I know what you want. Go get your toy. Come here. Oh, that was smart. That was a pretty smart move, dude.
Pretty smart doggy.
I'll do anything for my Supreme Ball.
Fucking hype beast ass dog.
Look at you. You hype beast.
What's wrong with you? Don't you know these motherfuckers are owned by Vans now? Vans. You trying to get caught slipping in some Vans, bro?
Hey, but Teddy, I like Vans.
Huh? Half cabs are nothing, though. Just don't play yourself.
Okay, this morning, I'm not actually running late. I sort of planned to go later because... Hold on, seatbelt. I want you to know that the seatbelt is not for my safety. It's because I don't want to hear the ding. But this morning, it's Monday. I tattooed yesterday. I'm tattooing today. The morning was spent arguing with mostly Dirty Earn on the internet about resale and my past here on this here channel, which is very interesting. Some people think me and Earn don't like each other as of this morning, or that we're actually fighting. We're not. This is what we do. At no time on this channel have I ever promoted anyone be a reseller or be all about the hype. I have always maintain that you should think for yourself. It's like Earn has just realized, like, he just woke up today and realized, like, what I was all about. I don't know. It's okay. We love each other. He's great. He's gonna figure it out. He hit on the turduncan, so he's just really hype about him, I guess. Going to the gym, squats and some deadlifts. We just closed down the lookbook. The prints for the King Kong were up all week last week, so I've got to get all that stuff going. Yeah, get the work week started and get all the orders placed. And I dropped my calories down a little bit because my weight has literally stayed the exact same for now 3 weeks, but that's actually, like, probably a good thing. Definitely noticed body changes. My measurements have all changed. I used a myotape to measure, so all of my measurements have changed, even though the scale didn't move, and I can totally see the difference. But I did drop them down a little bit. Drop them down for a week or two and see what happens, and then maybe even raise them back up. Again, not on a race to get skinny. I definitely want to keep as much muscle as possible. And then the only thing, other thing is last night I went on a nighttime bike ride, which was cold. I have to ride my bike a lot less, so I'm only able to really get in like one or two good bike rides a day, which are like 10 miles or over, and the rest of the week my rides are going to be under 5. So I think if I can get these like 4 or 5, but if I can get these 5 mile rides in at night way after going to the gym, that would be great. If I can't fit them in, I can't fit them in. It's okay. We're doing fine. We're doing great. We're doing plenty of activity. So that's the update. We're almost at the gym. We are gonna make some more fucking food. I literally just cook chicken like all the time. Some people have been asking me about my workout split, which I get from Lane Norton. I mean, I can design a workout program, I can do my own, but I don't want to. And there's so many out there, and a lot of it's confusing, and I don't want to, you know. I trust Lane Norton. It's not an ad, he's not pay me, and we do not communicate other than on Twitter sometimes. I just signed up on his website for $14.95 a month or something. It has a workout builder program, and it basically, you can pick from all these programs, and plug in your own variables, and enter it, and it changes as you progress. And I've been really enjoying it.
Hold on, I'll open this. There you go, some sun. Now you can lay there. We're not going out. I just did it for the sun. Crazy.
But yes, workouts. BioLane.com is what I've been doing. I'm gonna do that for the next few months until I decide to do something else. But right now I'm 5 weeks through a 12-week program, so we still have quite a bit of time. I also don't prep a lot of food in advance because I don't like the way that food tastes, especially chicken, when it's been prepped days and days and days in advance. So I just take the time and cook it, whatever. We're at home, what else am I gonna do?
Oh yeah, bitch, we already know, lunchtime.
I'm gonna be so fucking good.
Oh no. What ingredient are you missing?
Oh shit. What are we missing?
Lemon juice.
Nah, we got lemon juice.
Where?
In the fridge.
Get it right now. Give it to me.
What? Ooh, I forgot to tell the vlog. Baby Bear Drone sent me a Wilkinson. This is a $9 bottle of water. It's real friendship right there. I'm about to drink it here in a minute. What a day, Omar.
Oh man, fucking people have no idea.
Oh, God. People have no idea how good Wilkinson is. Wilkinson, the water from Japan. You fucking...
I don't know what.
All right. Good motherfucking morning. It is Tuesday. Tomorrow, we have to go to court for our red light running. Morning. It's a little later. I've been going to the gym a little later because I don't actually have to wake up at 4 a.m. It's just not necessary.
Doing up there?
It's much later. It's like 4 o'clock. I have been doing shit all day, mostly just computer stuff, emailing back and forth. And then really, honestly, guys, we're 3 weeks away from Jay coming home. So preparing mentally to see what's gonna happen. We don't know yet, but everyone that I've talked to who has experience with this says that it literally comes down to like the last few days. So I'm just putting myself in the mindset that it's going to happen because that is what I'm preparing for. That's happening, and then the rest, other than just working on the For Love or the Money drop, which the orders are in and the drop will be soon, we got new face masks in. Last time, face masks sold out so fast. First run was the multicolored sculage, but this time we have black and white sculages. I like to model my face mask with shades. I don't know why. It's my favorite way. So we have the sculage. Probably isn't like super straight. It's like, and then the happy cry. Those are gonna come out real soon. Those came in. Air fresheners are here. A few things going on the site. In the meantime, mystery bag. That's not what we're here to talk about. What we're here to really not talk about at all. Well, update, I guess. I am working on paintings like every day. I have stacks, a stack. Oh. Not approaching it the way I was. I was making these backgrounds, which was starting to kind of limiting me a little bit. What I started to do was just sketch a lot. So now I've started a new process where I'm going to draw directly on the paper, which is what I did at the beginning of quarantine with all of these paintings. So, which at the beginning of quarantine, I was like, oh, maybe I later could do an art show or something. Like, after all this ends. This is never gonna end. These paintings may end up going up for sale. The supply, if we get another shutdown, the country, it's gonna be, shit is gonna get fucked. You know what I'm saying? And I'm not, it's not a political statement. We'll do whatever it is we do. But supply chain of getting like garments and stuff is gonna be even slower than it is now. So I'm just kind of like preparing for the future here. See what happens. We're all just waiting to see what happens, bro.
Yeah, I think we're gonna be alright. I mean, shit, we only just need them to hold off for like 3 weeks, bro.
Yeah, I know. Well, what's your release date? What's the exact date? The 9th?
8th.
The 8th. Oh, that's actually a good thing. It's in the morning? You get released? What time? What are your sizes? Like your shirt and pants? Okay. 34. How tall you think you are, son? 34. Maybe you need the 34 to tuck into your Tims, you know what I mean? I understand. You're... and t-shirt what, extra large and hoodie extra large?
Yeah, extra large.
Then if it's a pant size, it's probably what, a large? Like a, if it's a, you know.
Yeah. And then I wrote my shoe size on there anyway.
It's 10 and a half, right?
Yeah.
I knew that already.
10 and a half. Some shit I can wear in 10, but some shit is just, like, Jay is running small for me, I guess. I don't know. Yeah, I'll call you in
a
couple more days.
I'm
very appreciative. I love you.
Yeah, love you too. I'll let you know if I hear anything. I'll email you.
Alright, brother.
Alright.
Alright, come on, let me out.
I will. She just got home.
Alright, brother.
Alright. Peace.
Good morning. It is, it's Wednesday. It is 18th. The only reason I know it's the 18th is because I know where we have to go.
The courthouse. All right, court is over. It's been so long since I've been to court that I forgot. If you're pleading no guilty, you basically don't do anything the first day except plead not guilty, and then they push you off for a court date. So we are effectively right now just wasting the city's money. This is gonna cost the city way more money. They're wasting my time, but we're wasting their money. They also gave me this piece of paper. Your trial has been set, but if you wanna call this number and negotiate the case before the trial, then you could do that, which I think would be kind kind of funny to just call and be like, yeah, it's for a bicycle ticket. So I'm, you guys want to throw this out or do we want to keep wasting everybody's money? And then it makes me mad because you sit there and you watch them. It wasn't that busy today, thank God, if it had been regular. You know, there's like maybe 9 people in court, but regularly, if there had been a full courtroom, this would have taken all fucking day, especially having the last name Safarian because I'm at the end of the list. You just sit there and watch them fucking tax people who already can't afford to live. Everyone in there was in there for a car that's not registered or some insurance that has lapped. And then their tickets are $700 and $400. It's such bullshit. Like sitting there just taxing motherfuckers. People who can't afford already to keep up. Fuck you. You know what I'm saying? And then I don't know. Like as a judge, I feel like I'd just be like, we're just extracting money from the poorest people in town. This is such a fucking joke. Like such a fucking joke. Like it's such a joke to sit there and watch it happen. Yeah. Ridiculous. Ridiculous. Makes me want to be a lawyer, to be honest.
Good morning. Today is Thursday. I legit have no idea where we left off. Today was an off day from the gym. I was so tired and hungry yesterday. Yeah, just kind of tired and like a little out of it. Did a podcast last night. I just did ordering all day. And when we do ordering for stuff, a lot of it comes from New York and California. It just is what it is. I feel like for the next, like, the rest of my lifetime, you're going to be hearing, well, then COVID happened. You know what I'm saying? Because it's literally the reasoning for everything. But yeah, so yesterday was kind of an uneventful day. I did some time painting.
Doing a lot of painting. I'm tired today too, man.
Ugh, I don't know why. Shouldn't be too tired. Need to go to the gym. We have a heavy day of lifting weights. And we have a swirly dragon at 2 o'clock.
Because we care about.
What is it?
Oh, wouldn't you like to know? This package is technology. Hundreds, if not thousands. Don't laugh. Thousands of years of technological innovation.
Oh my gosh, what? Hey, are we gonna be able to make zoodles?
Our days of. We've been able to make zoodles. Yes. We can make hash browns without ruining our hands because you had a fucking grater from like
6:36, we're cruising this morning. We're like rocket fueled. Yesterday, tired as fuck. Today, rocket fueled. So, you explain it. I can't. This week is wrapping up as far as my food intake goes. Still pretty easy. I mean, there's been some nights, I guess, where I wanted more food because I had to cut back my calories just a little bit. But not crazy. Nothing like too crazy. It's been pretty manageable. The gym has been great. All of my lifts have been like getting better. Everything's getting better. I'm about to just like spill everything. Yes, all the lifts have been getting better, bigger, feeling stronger. These are all, I am so, gotta live in like a fucking cul-de-sac. Okay, I'd be yelling at Alex if she was doing that. She's not here, is she? Plans for today, I have some phone meetings, you know, regular business stuff for me. Taking on a few projects from different things just because I have a little more time during the old COVID. On some stuff I can't tell you guys about yet. It'll come out later. But so there are some things I have to work on off camera. But that's part of life. You know, not everything is filmable. Just like the gym sessions. I don't think we'll ever get to a place where we're filming the full gym session. Yeah. I'm real excited about this morning. Upper body workout. Let's go.
Everybody's kicking it. Everybody's kicking it to the classics. Alex is doing some shipping.
Hi.
I'm just painting my little heart away. You can tell because my desk looks like this.
And this is how it looks when I'm being creative. Because this is how a genius's desk should look. Maybe without the Mountain Dew. It's not a very genius item to have it.
That's the week. Without the weekend. I'm tattooing all weekend. I just finished making some goddamn chicken. We have some fresh rice. Shout out to Dirty Urn for buying a PS5, passing it off for retail. And we're proud of him. We haven't lost him completely. A little crack of the old. It's like when you see Anakin in Darth Vader. You know what I mean? I am going to take a break. I can't visit Japan, so I'm going to like repaint the Japanese experience. I do like this little series so far, and I've obviously switched things up. Kind of the key to the project for me is to loosen up and tighten up, kind of dump out ideas all as one, you know, and have people who want them. So it's cool. I'm super hype on these little Japanese ones, though. Yeah, if I'm going to get any work done, I got to edit off this classical music. That is going to be the week. We're out of here. Peace.